Last time, we left off wondering if there was some formula or set of rules we could use to determine if a set of 81 pixels showed a finger or something else. Before we begin searching for a solution, let's simplify our problem a bit by reducing the number of possible intensity values for each pixel from 256 to just 2. We'll replace every pixel value greater than or equal to 92 with a 1, and every pixel value less than 92 with a 0. By reducing the possible values for each pixel, we've significantly simplified our problem while preserving the structure of our data. Our 9x9 grids around each pixel now only contain 1s and 0s. We can now really begin to think about solutions. Since we have a pretty good idea of what fingers look like, we should be able to write some code that captures this understanding. We can do this by creating our own 9x9 grid that shows what we expect a finger to look like. We can make this into a rule in Python by creating a 9x9 NumPy array, with ones where the finger is and zeros where it's not. If a 9x9 grid matches our pattern, it's a finger. If it doesn't, it's not. Now that we have a rule, let's test it. We'll search for matches to our pattern, and we'll indicate matches by coloring the central pixel of the matching grid on our original images. We see some matches, but we've missed most finger pixels. Why did our rule miss so many pixels? One reason is that our rule is way too specific. It only returns a match if the finger is exactly centered in the 9x9 grid of pixels we're considering. We would really like our finger-finding algorithm to return a match for any pixel that belongs to a finger, even if that pixel is not right in the center of the finger. We can fix this problem by simply adding more rules. We could manually enter more arrays of zeros and ones as we did with our first rule, but to save time, we'll write a Python loop that shifts our finger pattern around for us. This results in 30 new patterns that should help us identify more finger pixels. Our finger-finding algorithm now consists of searching for matches to any of our 30 patterns. If we color our images with our new matches, we see that our new approach does find more finger pixels. However, we're still missing quite a few, and perhaps a little bit more alarmingly, our algorithm is labeling some non-finger pixels as fingers. This brings us to an important point. There's more than one way in which our algorithm can be wrong. We could be wrong because we fail to identify finger pixels, or because we mislabeled pixels that actually don't belong to fingers. A popular way to represent this idea is with a confusion matrix. For a given image and algorithm to identify fingers, each pixel could belong to a finger or not, and may be labeled by our algorithm as a finger or not. This creates four total possibilities, two where our algorithm is correct, and two where it's not. This distinction between the two types of errors, false positives and false negatives, is not such a big deal for our application. But there are other types of problems where this distinction is critical. If we're predicting heart attacks, a false positive means you're prepared for a heart attack and nothing happens, while a false negative means you give the all clear and the patient does have a heart attack. The difference between false positives and false negatives is far less important to us, but we'll still keep track of both of these to see how we're doing. Speaking of how we're doing, how are we doing? We can see that we're making errors of each type, but we would really like to know exactly how many. To count our errors, we need correct labels to compare our labels to. We could label images by hand, by manually marking each pixel as belonging to a finger or not. This would work just fine, but is of course slow. Instead, we'll use LeapMotion hand tracking software and some custom Python code to determine correct finger labels. Now that we have the correct labels for each pixel, we can measure exactly how well our finger-finding rules are performing. We can see that our algorithm is correctly identifying some finger pixels, but is still missing most of them. At this point, we have an important decision to make. Should we continue with our current strategy or reevaluate? We certainly could improve our current approach. We've accounted for different locations of fingers in our 9x9 grid, but we haven't yet considered different rotations or sizes of fingers. To help us decide which strategy is best, next time we'll visit artificial intelligence in the 1980s.